Hey guys, Gun here. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about gear requirements for Merciless Onward and what kind of items you want to be looking for in order to be able to clear the content on your own. All of the stuff I'm going to talk about here focuses on solo play and not on group play, because if you are playing in a group, the content becomes a little bit easier, and in some cases, if you have a lot of synergy in the party, it becomes much easier. But you still want to have a character that is able to solo the content, because if your friends aren't online and you want to play some Path of Exile and your character isn't capable of doing so, you are kinda screwed. And because of that, I'm going to tell you what kind of gear you need to be able to clear content on Merciless and then clear content on maps. Alright, if you reach Merciless, you want to have maximum resistances. As you can see, I'm close to the cap on all three and I'm capped at Lightning. And this is without any buffs. I have Enduring Charges, 5 of them. If I use Enduring Cry, I get Endurance Charges. And for each Endurance Charge, I get 5% Elemental Resistances. And this means that I get 25% Elemental Resistances, and this puts me over the cap. And I have even more resistances. This flask over here gives 27% additional Elemental Resistances. And together with Endurance Charges, this puts me way above the cap, and that's also necessary, because there are enemies that curse you, that can curse you and lower your resistances, and if you are only at the cap and they lower your resistances, they will one-shot you if you don't have the necessary life in order to survive the attack, and you probably won't if you reach the content for the first time. And because of that, you want to be close to the cap, as close as possible, and with buffs even above the cap. Especially if you start doing maps, you want to be above the cap, because this gives you a lot of flexibility for, let's say you want to replace an item like this because you found a better item, but if you replace the item, you lose something like 30% cold resistance. If you aren't close to the cap, you can't really replace the item because you would be prone to cold damage. But because I'm so already at the cap without any buffs, I can replace this item and use stuff like the flask or endurance charges to still be above the cap and be safe in maps. And that's what you want to be aiming for. You want to be at the cap without any buffs, and with buffs you want to be above the cap. That way you can do maps that have the mod minus player resistances or elemental weakness, or a map that has enemies that can curse you and lower your resistances. Another thing you want to be focusing on is life. You want to have for Merciless, you want to have about 2500 to 3500 life, otherwise you won't be able to clear the content. And this is mainly due to the amount of damage you will take. There are enemies that deal quite a lot of damage in a single hit, and if you are hit by several of these attacks, you will die quite fast, even if you are using a granite flask in order to mitigate some of the physical damage. You will still take quite a lot of damage. And if you don't have at least 2500 to 3500 life, you will die in every area you will enter. And that's my recommendation. Get a lot of life, get a lot of resistances, and then you can focus on damage. And if you encounter something that has quite a lot of life, something like a rare rock golem with life regeneration, you aren't obligated to kill him. You can just skip him. If you don't have enough damage yet, because you focus on survivability first, you don't need to kill all of the rares in the area. Just skip the ones that have too much life or regeneration and keep going in the area. And I will show you the items that you want to be looking for. Items like this. This has 12% implicit all Rezi and 23 additional lightning Rezi and 83 maximum life. And additional strength, which also gives additional life. This gives a lot of life and resistances. This helmet over here gives quite a lot of life in through strength and maximum life, and also has resistances. This pair of boots over here have triple resistances and quite a lot of life, and these have quite a lot of life as well. You want to have as much life as possible, and this belt over here has a lot of life. If I take off this belt, as you can see, I have 4400 life. If I take off the belt, I lose about 500 life or even more than that. And you want to focus on a lot of life on gear, and then you want to focus on elemental resistances. And once you are capped and have quite a lot of life, you can focus on damage. Something like adds physical damage, adds fire damage, or critical strike chance, more damage, and more elemental damage, fire damage, lightning, 17% increased elemental damage, and stuff like that. And basically, that's just a luxury, because you don't really need damage to clear the content. You can clear all of the content with rather low damage, except for high life rares, and as I said, you can skip them until you have better gear. And then, if you have enough life, enough resistances, so ability, more armor and stuff like that, and if you are playing a Chaos Inclination character, you want to focus on energy shield, obviously, instead of life. You want to focus on energy shield first and then resistances. And as I said, if you have enough survivability in terms of life or energy shield, armor and resistances, then you can start focusing on damage. And if you got enough damage, you can focus on stuff like quantity find and rarity find, as is the case with this helmet over here, which has double quantity rarity. And that way you get quite a lot of more items and farm a lot faster and more efficiently and can upgrade your character in a more efficient manner. And once you start doing maps, you want to have even more life than 3500. You want to have about 4000 to 5000 life, if not 6000 life. I don't have 6000 life because my character is already quite efficient. He has quite a lot of armor, quite a lot of life regen, quite a lot of life. And I can already do the content without having to worry about my survivability. And that's why I stopped skilling life nodes. But if you are still struggling with the content because you take too much damage, you can still get a lot more life. And it's also necessary, because in maps, some of the enemies hit for 2000 to 3000 without armor. And even with armor, they will hit for quite a lot, because armor is diminished in effectiveness if it faces a relatively large hit. The more damage you take with a single hit, the less your armor protects you against it. And because of that, you want to have as much life or energy shield as possible. And as I said, in maps you want to have over the max resistances, because there are enemies that can curse you, or you can roll the mob with roll the map with a mod that decreases your resistances or elemental weakness, which also decreases your elemental resistances. And if you aren't on the cap with only the minimum gear that you have, then you won't be able to do these maps, because once you enter them and you are lowered to something like 20% resistances, you will instantly die as soon as you are hit by elemental damage. But as I already showed you, I have stuff like this flask over here, or endurance charges, that will still put me at the cap again. And that way I can do maps without having to worry about elemental resistances. And that's basically it. First you want to focus on life and resistances, and in case of energy shield users, energy shield obviously instead of life. And then you can use something like a granite flask to increase your armor, which is also very useful. And after that you can get damage and stuff like quantity and rarity find. And that's basically it. And I completely forgot to mention the weapon. The weapon is the most important thing when it comes to doing damage. You will focus on survivability on all of your other gear, and focus on as much damage as possible on your weapon, obviously. If you have a really good weapon, you can clear all of the content without having to worry about damage at all. And obviously this bow over here is quite good, and that's why I'm able to focus solely on survivability without having to worry about damage. And that's basically it. See you guys next time.